All right, so I think it's high time that we go over once again one of the most popular forms of external media, the USB stick. And this is actually a first for this channel because I'm going to be showing you how to recover files from one of these things, a USB stick, on your Mac computer. So, without wasting any more time, let's get into it. So as I've talked about before, USB flash drives are an amazing source of external memory, and they've been around forever, meaning that most likely you have at least one of these things floating around at your desk somewhere. Unfortunately though, many users of these things face accidental deletion and formatting, and when it comes to the Mac, there's not a whole lot of great tutorials or great solutions even out there for you to get your files back all intact and 100% as they were. And so today I really have two goals. One is going to be explaining to you just what happens when you delete files or you format them or you accidentally lose them from a drive like this. And second, I'm going to be giving you three total methods that you can use and employ the next time you want to get your files back from a USB stick. So first, what happens when files get deleted? Well, there's one rule that we need to keep in mind, one rule only, and that is stop using the USB stick. And the reason why is because we're trying to prevent something called overwriting. Now, that's a word that I use a lot on this channel, but the reason why is because whenever you delete a file off of one of these, that file is marked as available space waiting to be overwritten by new files that come in later on. So what we're trying to do is preventing overwriting that file so that we can actually get it back in its fully intact state. Because by that time the file is overwritten, it's completely gone. And so that's why we always tell our users and everyone that watches this channel to stop using their devices as soon as they delete the files or format them, because that gives you the best chance of getting all of your files back, because what you're essentially doing is freezing it in time. Now this is a concept that I'll talk about a little bit more later on in the video, but now let's get into method number one, which is of course, checking your trash bin. So when you delete something on your Mac, whether it's from a USB stick or the internal memory, whatever it is, it will always go to the trash bin first instead of being deleted forever. And this is pretty handy because what it means is we can just check the trash bin and see if our stuff is there. So let's go ahead and do that now. So you can go ahead and usually find the trash bin to the far right end of your dock, and you can click on it and see what files might be there after deleting them. You might have a lot of stuff in here, so you can go up to the search bar and search for the file that you want if you happen to know its name. And if you find it, simply right-click on it and select Put Back. So at this point, if you found your file in the trash bin, then you should be good to go. It'll be completely restored to the place where it was before, which in this case would be your USB stick. So you could check there to find your file. But I know that that's pretty basic and many of you probably already thought of that already. So let's move on to number two, which is actually checking the individual trash folder that could be on your USB stick. So the cool thing about macOS is that whenever there's files that are kept on an external drive like a USB stick, anytime that they're deleted, a copy of them is kept in a hidden folder on the actual drive itself. Now I refer to this as the trash, but they are hidden by default, so you will need to do a little bit of digging in order to find them. But don't worry, I'll walk you through it. So first we're going to be going over the method for the operating system Sierra or later. So let's go ahead and do that right now. In this one case, it's actually very simple. You can unhide the folders that you want to view simply by using Shift, Command, and period. Now, if you're using the previous version of Mac, it's a little bit more complicated, but again, I'm going to walk you through it, so just pay attention. First, go ahead and open the Terminal app on your Mac. Now, we're going to be using two commands today, both of which will be pasted in the description for you to copy so that you can follow along. But we're first going to paste in this command, and once you do so, go ahead and hit Return. Now after this, go ahead and copy the second command, which again will be in the description, back into Terminal, and once again, press Return like so. Now after running these commands, you should be able to go back to your USB stick and see that the hidden .trashes folder is now uncovered. And you can even empty it from Finder to clear some of the space on the USB stick, if you happen to be running low on space. Now once you're done and you want to hide those folders again, simply enter those same three commands, but replace true with false. But either way, once you find the .trashes file, you can sift through it to see if it contains any of the files that you recently deleted. So now that's a pretty sweet method, but sometimes not even that works, and you need to actually go into the individual sectors of the drive and piece back the files together to actually get them back for you. And we can't do that ourselves, but luckily there is a piece of software that we can use, and that's called a disk drill. So I've used Disk Drill before many times, obviously, and I talk about it on this channel a lot because it's the best software solution out there, especially for Mac. It's constantly being updated and it's extremely powerful, being able to go in and not only extract files, but also piece together files that have been either formatted, corrupted, or deleted so that it's extremely robust and almost foolproof. Like, I have rarely had a bad recovery with this software. And so, let's use it. So go ahead and go down to the link in the description, which will allow you to download and install Disk Drill. And once you've installed it, go ahead and launch it. Now when you launch it, there will be a few tutorials that you can run through if you want, but once you get past those, it will bring you to the main recovery panel, which will show you a list of all the drives that are connected to your computer. Now at this point, if you have not already, go ahead and connect your USB drive to your Mac. And once you've done that, it should appear in the list of drives within Disk Drill. You can go ahead and click the recover button over to the right. Now at this point, of course, depending on how big your USB drive is, you're gonna have to wait a little bit, so we'll exercise some patience for a minute here, and I'll get back to you when it's done. All right, it's all done, and from here we can review the files that have been found in the same area as the disk list right here. So it's a lot like a folder structure. You can just sift through the different scan types, and you will be able to see which files have been found for that specific scan. And eventually you should come across the files that you originally deleted. Now, one thing that I need to touch on here is you need to make sure that these files are previewable. And what this means is that the file is able to be viewed in full inside of Disk Drill. And you can actually check this by clicking this little preview icon right here. And the reason why this is important, again, is we're trying to make sure that these files are not overwritten. And if they are not overwritten and therefore are completely intact, they will be 100% previewable. And if that's the case, then you can go ahead and recover those files. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that right now. So go ahead and find the file that you want to recover and put a check mark next to it and then choose your save location. Something else that's important is you do not want to export or save the files to the same place that you're trying to recover from. So do not export the files to the USB stick if you're trying to recover from the USB stick. That's something that's really important. And after that, click recover. And now as you can see, the files have been recovered to my save location, which was my desktop, and they're all intact. Safe and ready to go. So that is how you recover files from a USB stick, whether deleted, formatted, whatever, on a Mac. That's something that I've been wanting to go over for a while, as there's been some new methods that I've come across that I wanted to share with you guys, and I hope that you guys did find this helpful. And if you did, always be sure to leave us a like down below. Also, if you have any questions or comments or things you want me to cover in a future video, let us know down below in the comments section. But that's gonna be it for this video today. My name is Andy, and until next time, thank you for watching.